red carpet, it's time for The Edit. I'm Laura McGee, he's David Farrell. Look at that wee face there. This is The Edit, so let's see what's making the cut this week.
Hi, we're jealous. We are going to be back on The Edit talking all about the brand new record, the album, the tour, and when we're coming back to see you in Scotland.
And the Scotland's entertainment world gets back to normal. I'm here at Transmit, taking a look at what you can see and do in the next couple of weeks.
And R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to Jennifer Hudson to be playing Aretha Franklin in a new movie about her life. Hello there and welcome to The Edit. And David, I've got a bone to pick with you because I'm feeling very lonely in the studio this week because you've left me to hang out with proper pop stars and celebs at Transmit right now. Not happy, but a little birdie told me that that's not the only pop stars you've been speaking to this week.
Laura, I'll be honest, I think I'm kind of glad I'm this far away from you because there's a lot of anger there, but honestly, I could only get one ticket. You know what the situation is, and the next time I'll certainly bring you. But yeah, there's lots of big stars at Transmit and other big stars. We need to talk about GLS, Jack the Lad Swing. The boys are back, and this is the best news I've heard in a long time. They've got a brand new album, they've got a tour coming out, and Amy and I caught up with them earlier.
Watch the sun go down under city lights. Talk about our life, people we don't like. Nobody can judge our past. We'll
be to be back with such, you know, welcome, open arms from, you know, all of the fans. You know, the way they've been, you know, streaming and downloading Eternal Love. It's like we were living JLS, you know, the JLS we were 8 years ago in this era. It's like nothing has ever changed, and they've made us feel so welcome.
It's like a comfort blanket, honestly, to have you guys back. It just feels like the world is healing.
It takes us back to better times, doesn't it?
It does. You mentioned the new single, of course, Eternal Love, written by Ed Sheeran for you guys. Who phoned Ed Sheeran? How did that all come about?
We first met Ed at Her Majesty the Queen's Diamond Jubilee in 2012. Backstage, in her house at the palace. I mean, that's really bougie, but it's the truth, right? So we met Ed then. We both, you know, were very complimentary of each other, how much we're fans of each other. Then fast forward, Ed had written a record for us, Lego House, but it never got to us, right? And then fast forward to this year, 2021, yeah, we put in the call to Ed and Steve Mack, who produced Beat Again for us, and they're in the studio and wrote this record, and it's like, you know, meant to be.
How raging were you when you found out that you should have had Lego House?
I mean, apparently, well, you say raging, but apparently it didn't sound anything like Ed's version of Lego House, so that's fine.
Yeah.
So whatever version it was, that's fine. Like, it's good.
So we're going to see you in Scotland next month, kicking off the tour in Scotland. So it's good that you've chosen this part of the world to bring GLS live back.
We always say there's not many places, if any, rather than Scotland in general. I think it's, you know, you can't, listen, especially when you come to like the main cities like Glasgow and everyone kind of just flocks in from everywhere. It's a bit like, I mean, that's probably some of our biggest pandemonium moments I think.
But guys, you do need to tell us, of course, I've not seen it in person, but I know David has, the song that you always sing when you perform in Scotland.
This is my favourite. This is my favourite GLS song.
Oh, you can't show your granny off a bus. Oh, you can't show your granny off a bus. Oh, you can't show your granny because she's your mommy's mommy. Oh, you can't show your granny off a bus.
Hey! Do you know, people have been excited about ABBA getting back together. That is what I needed. Tell us about the album as well.
I mean, 2.0. Album 2.0. Honestly, for us, it's definitely one of our best albums yet, if not the best.
Okay.
You know, I mean, you know, we've been writing all through lockdown, being creative, and I think, you know, with lockdown, although it's been rough for us all, the positives that we took out of it was we had that quiet time when the whole world stopped. And so all we could do was write music and amongst other things. But you know, it was definitely therapeutic. And
now, guys, here on The Edit, we do love to play a wee game with whoever we've got on the programme. And we've got one for you that we've called One Shot. And it's very simple. You have one opportunity. You have to shout out, whoever's first can tell me which one of your songs these lyrics are from.
Lyric number one. Would it always haunt you, baby, that you missed your chance to save me?
That's the beat again!
Yay!
Aston's in there, okay.
Okay, next one. Out of sight, they say out of mind.
Eyes wide shut.
Yep, one each, right, okay. Next one. Standing by the bar, just enjoying the view.
I had it in the bag, baby. The club is alive, I had it in the bag. Let's go.
Arishi point. Right, okay, JB, come on.
JB, there's a chance for you to pull it back. Next one. Takes a little fire to keep things hot.
Crazy for you.
Yeah.
Barvin's in the lead.
Yes. Okay.
We've only got one more.
One more. Right, silence, guys. Feel the pressure here. I can tell you that you can't stay here, knowing just as soon as you disappear that I'll be missing you, baby.
I do recognise you.
JB! Everybody laugh. Yes! Back in the game.
What a tune, David Farrell. It is so good to have them back. I'm loving the addition of the umbrella. It's obviously started raining at Transmit. But most importantly, did you get the result of the quiz?
Yeah, do you know what? We're not going to rain on GLS's parade with the score. I mean, it wouldn't be an Edit quiz, Laura, if we, of course, didn't have an Edit winner. Here's why.
I think, though, from that, Marvin got two.
Well done, Marvin. We'll give you the 2 points.
How did Marvin... How did he win?
Rematch to my Scottish brother and sister.
Thank you.
So, David, you left me on my own here in the studio so you can saunter away and have a cheeky wee day out at Transmit with all your pals. I know what you're doing. Are you feeling any guilt about enjoying what's left of a summer festival season without me?
Well, Laura, now that you keep bringing it up, I'm maybe feeling a little bit of guilt, but honestly, next time I'll make it up to you, I promise. Now, if Transmit isn't your thing or you're not looking for some live music, what about the theatre, Laura? Can I make it up to you with a wee trip to the theatre?
Well, I don't know if I want to be doing that with you now.
Right, OK, I'll go myself then. 9 to 5, the musical is on at the Edinburgh Playhouse, and at the King's in Glasgow, Chicago is on there. So theatres are back, and of course at the Hydro, the first big indoor event at the Hydro since the beginning of the pandemic. That opens with Scotland's Strongmen. There's comedy at the Armadillo as well with Ricky Gervais. And if you want to stay in and you know, it's getting chillier at night, you want to curl up in front of the TV, some big TV shows are back. Strictly is sparkling and cha-chaing onto our screen very soon. And Laura, do you have a sweet tooth?
No. I'm far more of a crisps person.
Oh, I'm just really not winning at all at this, am I? Well, this one isn't for you then. The Bake Off is back on our screens in the next couple of days as well.
Now, from TRN, SMT to RES, PECT, David Farrell, I am shocked that I managed to get that all out in one take.
And I'll have a consonant, please, Laura. Add in GLS to that as well. And I mean, it is like a tricky hand at Scrabble, isn't it?
Well, indeed. Less of a puzzler, though, is the new Aretha Franklin biopic and our Jodie Met star of the show, Jennifer Hudson, to hear all about it.
We know that in this movie you are playing Aretha Franklin, but what can audiences expect? How much of her journey are we going to learn about?
The life, you know, as well, and the journey to her legacy.
I want to sing what I want to sing.
The icon that she became and the treasure that she is to us all, you know, I think it gives it so much more substance and an understanding when you can see the circumstances and of the life. And what it took for her to become who she became.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Okay.
Find out what it means to me.
You really like it?
We love it, Ree.
Ree.
Ree, Ree.
Ree, 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 Ree.
It's really good.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me.
I got a single by this new chick named Aretha Franklin.
And could you have ever imagined when you were a wee girl singing her songs that one day not only would you be playing her in a movie, but that she actually handpicked you to play this, am I right?
That's something you can never even imagine up. Like, who would even have the nerve to dream that big, you know?
Do you see what she is?
Became a dream of mine to want to play her, but it never crossed my mind that it would, you know, she would want the same, which is like, it's exciting, but it makes it scary too, you know, even more like, yeah. Oh my God, because it made it that much more personal to me and for me.
Yeah, and see, because it did mean so much to you, do you feel like this is probably the hardest you've ever worked on a project because you wanted to get it right?
You don't want to let somebody like Aretha Franklin down. You know, if someone believes in you that much to give you that, and then being a fan and knowing who she is, what she represents to us all and for us all, it's like, okay. And to be left with an assignment like that, I still sit with it and be like, okay, what more can I do?
You always do more and you always blow us away. You're so, so talented. And of course, Aretha, Queen of Soul, she is an icon to so many, an inspiration to so many, but as are you. So what's your message to the people that look up to you and would love to play you one day?
Oh, goodness. You know what? Keep at your dreams. If you keep at it, it has no choice but to give in. And just what Aretha left me with, it wasn't until she owned her voice that we got our Queen of Soul. So if we all took the time to search within ourselves to find our treasure, what king and queen is under there?
She's a miracle.
Oh, how good does that look? Well, that's all we have time for today. Thanks to David over at Glasgow Green, having a whale of a time, as you can see. You can catch up on all things Transmit on BBC iPlayer. Check out the BBC Scotland channel on there. We'll be back next week with more celebos. Until then, enjoy the rest of your night. Bye-bye.